by Adrian, Paul, Nancy, and Svetlana, the proposal should not be jointly married. They should declare it now. Svetlana and Adrian. Today we will exchange vows of marriage, which will unite you as husband and wife before this company of family and friends. These vows are a formal and public pledge of your love and a promise of lifelong commitment to each other. But before you are both joined in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows that you are about to make. Marriage, according to the law of this country, is the union of one man with one woman, voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. In a moment, you each have to make a declaration that you are free to marry and then a marriage contract. And after you have spoken these words, as prescribed by law, you will then become husband and wife. So, Adrian, if you are free to marry, would you please repeat after me? I declare that I know of no legal reason. Why I, Adrian Paul Murphy, may not be joined in marriage, to Svetlana, and now the solemn moment has come, so Svetlana and Adrian make their formal and legal contract before the Lord. So once again, I'd ask for everyone to stand. Symbolizing unending and everlasting love, and is the outward sign of the life. strong promises he has just made to his brother. Adrian, I give you this ring as a symbol of our marriage. I promise you, darling, faithful and loyal to you in living our married life together. I promise you, darling, svetlana and Adrian, you have both made the declaration required by law, and have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of Roger and Paul, your family, friends, and the peers today. This day is the start of a new life for you today. We hope the feeling of love that you have for each other will be preserved as a stronger throughout the years to come, and it therefore does give you the greatest of pleasure to now announce you as husband. Oh.